bank assets rise to 39.8 trillion as non-performing loans fall to 14.9%. Chipa admitted as stakeholder at USA. DFCU records growth in revenues, fall in profits. Tanzania farm gets nod to import raw material for wire products tax-free. And California to ban sales of petrol-only vehicles by 2035. Thank you so much for joining us on the show this week. My name is Simon. Across the East African region, all the national airlines, Kenya Airways, Tanzania Air, and Uganda Airlines are struggling and currently operating under losses. Experts are warning that if strategies are not improved to ensure that these airlines start posting profits, then it's just a matter of time before all of them step away. The challenge for them is that they are currently operating in areas that have been deemed less profitable. We just can't tell how long this will be, but of course, look, with COVID happening and limited travels here and there, tourism sector itself still trying to pick up, the question is just how long these airlines will stay afloat to start making some money. Thank you for joining us. Let's get the show started. Once again, welcome to the show. Now, for those of you that watch The Business Show, you know for a fact that we're here to give all the different solutions that you need for your businesses. We speak to different experts who tell us what you need to do as a business person to continue making the profits. Like we keep saying, if you try something and it doesn't work out, it doesn't necessarily mean that you step out and try another thing. Sometimes it's important to pay attention to the details internally before you can look for other options and moving out to start another business. Starting another business does not necessarily mean that you are going to thrive. It's important that you pay attention to the nitty-gritties within the business so you can start making some money. This week on Views from the Top, we'll be speaking to an expert, and there'll be a high net investors conference or summit happening happening next month. Yeah, and we'll be speaking to one of the key organizers, and the theme of the summit will be investment in Uganda for inclusive prosperity. Now, we know for a fact that several summits have been held in Uganda, but the question is, what is in it this time for Ugandan companies? That and more in Views from the Top.
My name is Mohan Rao. I'm the chairman of Indian Association Uganda. Indian Association is formed in 1922 in Uganda, and now we are making 100 years. In this 100 years, we are making few programs. One program, 100 years on remark of 100 heart surgeries for needy Ugandan children we are doing. Second one is this Afro-Indian Summit. This Afro-Indian Summit, you see, we are not trading within African countries. This summit can make trade within the African countries. We are mainly focusing within the African countries, all 54 countries. We are calling each African country 10 top business people to come and invest in Uganda or trade with our factories or industries. And we are going to showcase all manufacturing industries, what products they are manufacturing in Uganda. And you see, many factories are operating under capacity. Means we are not having maximum sales. Whatever capacity is there, sales are not there. When sales are not there, they're reducing the production. Then means we are not operating full scale of any industry. For this, we wanted to develop market. That's why we are calling all African countries for a business meet. Uganda is my country. I'm staying in Uganda, living in Uganda last 30 years. Okay, we don't have a home in India right now to say we are Ugandans. We wanted to prosperous our Ugandan country. You know, this business summit can bring lot of deals or lot of investments inside the country. I prefer value addition on agriculture products. You see, we have a lot of agricultural produce. We are wasting a lot of agricultural produce without exporting. And you know, sometimes we are throwing out a lot of mangoes, a lot of things now. We need to focus on value addition projects. Like His Excellency President always says, value addition is the one country can bring as a prosperous in this country. Once value addition started, you see, right now we are making, for example, 3,000 tons we are producing cocoa. And if you do value addition, 50% value addition will increase. Means 50% whatever we are exporting, that revenue will increase. So that with that, country will benefit. Dollar income will come in. Yes, we are taking all sectors. We are taking Ministry of Trade, we are taking mining, we are taking agriculture is the main focus now in this event, and we are taking oil and gas energy, totally Ministry of Health also we are taking, totally we are taking and projecting seven sectors. These seven sectors have a lot of prosperity in this country. It is a very peaceful country. Always I refer as a three P's: peaceful, pleasant and prosperous. Peaceful means I can walk, I can drive in night in this country without any security. And security is very good in this country. Some of the African countries, we cannot move that way. And pleasant, always weather is pleasant. In this country, we get two crops without any irrigation. And we have a very good weather, temperature ranges very well. It's not like we don't have a snow like European countries, like Arab countries, we don't have very hot, you know. Our country temperatures are very mild and medium to stay around. And next one, profitable. We are business people. We do a business and we take our profits to other countries to invest, or we are investing in, so many people, majority people, they are investing here. If you want to take even other countries also your profit, there is no problem in this country. We pay taxes and take the profit. Many companies are doing, foreign country companies are taking. That's why I'm telling you, this is profitable country, means we can do anything without any disturbance. Certain countries we have restrictions, but this country is not having any restriction. It is friendly for investors. That's why I encourage our investors to come over here. And Indian Association also want to encourage. We made 100 years here now. As a trader, 1904, first one of our Indian trader entered in this country. And everybody is prosperous. We are living happily. This is what we wanted to showcase in the business summit, because it's a live example I can see. Then another thing, whatever expulsion has happened in 1972, it is a sad issue. But current president, he has released all the properties. Whoever claiming the properties, they got it. We are happy about that. You know, then what else you want in this country? This is what we have, a security, we have everything. And that's why we were encouraging our people to come and invest here. This is actually, it's a good concept what we are taking up. I see within African countries, trade is very low. You trade to Dubai or any other country, from there other countries are taking it up. Like for example, we are trading cocoa. Cocoa is going from here to Dubai, Dubai to Europe, Europe to India. Why we are not trading directly to India? There is a taxation issues, import taxation issues. Like that, this summit aims within African countries summit, means trading within African countries. Western Africa needs some material from Eastern Africa. Eastern Africa can trade with Western Africa like other countries of the Africa. For this is what we wanted to aim, and that's why we are taking main priority on the African countries. Then rest of the world also we are inviting to have our trade to be expanded. But our main aim is that within the African countries trade we wanted to develop it. Like South Sudan is there. Earlier they are buying from some other countries. Now when East Africa is open, they'll buy from Uganda. Uganda will be the most beneficiary country. Recently I heard about Kishoro Industrial Park. This park is very good idea for Congo. And this is opening borders for Ugandans. We can establish our business in Keshoro and our transport cost, other costs will be saved. And we will be the best people to sell to Congo.
Well, interesting conversation, and the debate has always been the incentives given to business people, well, the investors that come in here. The CSOs will tell you too much of the tax holiday does not favor growth in the country or in the economy, because when you give 10 years to these foreign investors, the one thing they will tell you is we are going to create 10,000 jobs in the next 4 years. The question is just how realistic is this, and also the jobs they create, do they really match the tax holiday that they are given? Well, we can only wait to see how this unfolds. You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Feel free to get in touch with us on our social media handles right below your screen. Just tell us what you think about the show. Plus, like I keep saying, the topics that you think we should have experts here to talk about, and we'll be more than glad. I'll see you after the break. Stay with us.